time. You know I am. Just a country boy trying to make it happen. Gary is a local singer-songwriter, trying to get the word out about his music and stuff. He's also an English teacher at, where are you teaching at, Gary?
West Claremont High School.
West Claremont High School.
Let's go Wolves.
And well, thank you so much for coming out and being with us. Gary was recommended by a dear friend of mine, John. He is the president of the Northern Kentucky Music Legends Association. I'll get this right. And John's just a super, super nice guy. He said, hey, Gary, got this guy you need to hear. So here we are. Give us a little background. You live in Alexandria.
Yes, I do.
Yep. Raised in Cold Spring.
Yep.
And when did you start playing? When did you get the love for music?
Yeah, so it started pretty young. I remember in grade school discovering the Beatles and my dad was into some older stuff. But then my senior year in high school, I managed to land the lead in a production of Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat and discovered I could sing a little bit. And then from there, I met some guys in college and was singing in bands. And I was always fascinated with the drums, so I taught myself the drums. And I was a drummer and lead singer in several bands. I thought I was Levon Helm, you know. And then in some bands, we tried our hand at originals, and it was cool. But then I got into cover bands. But in about 2010, I wanted to write some of my own songs. And so my buddy Dan Walsh, who I've played music with for a long, long time, he showed me some chords, and I just wanted to be able to play some of my own music. So there that's what kind of started it. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Who were some of your early influences?
Well, I love the Black Crowes, so rock and roll music. I remember seeing them in the early 90s at River Bend. They opened up for Aerosmith and just fell in love with them. And that started my love of rock and roll. And then, you know, the band, Levon Helm, as I mentioned.
Right.
But when I started getting into songwriting, I'm a huge fan of John Prine. I mean, just, you know, who doesn't love John Prine? And so, of course, and I went through kind of a Bob Dylan phase, of course, and then like some newer acts like Ray LaMontagne, singer-songwriter, and the Avett Brothers, fantastic, you know, folk rock band,
sure,
stuff like that, yeah. Yeah.
And somehow you got in. What do you, John says, when we were talking, I said, John, what kind of music do you play? Well, it's kind of a mix between bluegrass, country, folk, you know,
John's got it. I mean, yeah, right. I feel like that's it. I mean, my roots are in rock and roll music, but, you know, as you get older, things kind of change a little bit, and it's certainly acoustic music, but I say it's folk rock, or sometimes I call it rocky folk, just to be silly or whatever, but I always tell people, I'm a singer-songwriter, and it's folk rock music to me.
So how did you get this young man involved? Mr. Brandon.
Yeah. So the band is called Gary Birch and the Blamers. So okay, it's Gary Birch and so anybody who comes up on stage with me is a Blamer.
It's
so
a Blamer.
On my website, I got a whole list of Blamers, and Gary, you could be a Blamer someday.
Okay.
Who knows?
All right.
And so I just get to forget. My oldest son plays saxophone. He's working on his master's degree at Thomas More University. He couldn't be here today, but we do a lot of father-son gigs, so that's really, really cool. And so I've got me on acoustic and him doing lead on saxophone, which is different, which John Mendel has heard several times. And this young guy is my nephew, Brandon Vieth, and he is a guitar player extraordinaire, and he's taught me whatever I know about guitar, and I've taught him about Star Wars. We're both really big Star Wars fans, so there's that.
Yep,
pretty
much.
We have one of those guys here too.
Nice.
Actually, I think he's Star Trek. Same thing.
I'm a Star Trek fan too, but yeah.
I think John Harrell does a big band show for us. I think he's a Trekkie.
Nice.
Yeah. And we have all kinds of music here for those of you that are first time listening, because I know we got some first time listeners. Because we have Gary's class listening, part of his class listening.
That's right.
They may get graded on this, so you call all your friends up and say, hey, your classmates, and say, hey, you better listen to this. We may get quizzed on it tomorrow.
That's right. Quiz tomorrow, everybody. Quiz tomorrow, students. Here we go.
So without further ado, how about playing us a couple songs, introducing a couple of your songs to us, and let's see how this thing goes.
Yeah, would love to. So I released a single the day before Thanksgiving. It's my first ever single that I've released. I've always done albums. And so I wrote a song about my uncle, Albert Birch. And he and I were very close. He had Down syndrome. He was born in 1931 and he died in 1999. And he was just a unique guy, a unique character. And he coined a phrase. He used to say hot durn all the time. That was his thing. Hot durn this and hot durn that if he got mad about something or whatever. And so in the course of writing songs over the last year or so, I wanted to write a song about him. And one of the funny stories with him is I was visiting him one day in the early 90s, and he had stopped smoking cigarettes. And my dad told me, he'd smoke cigarettes since the time he was a teenager. I said, Uncle Al, why'd you stop smoking cigarettes? He said, yeah, I'm sick of the hot darn government raising the hot darn prices. And I said, so you just quit? Yeah, I'm not paying those prices. And
right.
that's in the song. And then he used to sell raffle chances down US 27 in Cold Spring and
okay.
Highland Heights, and Ameristop would let him come in, or Kroger, and they'd let him sit there, and some nice soul, he would hitchhike. And back then you could do that. And he would,
right.
they would pick him up, and he would set up his card table and have all these raffle chances from various organizations. And his tagline was, you feel lucky? So when you walked in the store, you feel lucky? I went to buy a chance, and people remember him selling chances, and I put that in my song too.
Right.
So this is my new single, and it's called Hot Dirt. Ready, babe? Politicians raised prices today. Uncle Al is throwing his cigarettes away. He'll keep his cool wig and TV dinner tray. Now and now, selling chances today. Down 27, a thumb in the air. Someone will stop. Someone who cares, hitching a ride to the Ameristop store. Oh, I will set up right next to the door. Hot darn politicians raised prices today. Uncle Al is throwing the cigarettes away. He'll keep his cool lid and TV dinner tray. Now heading out, selling chances to me. Feel lucky, he asks, as you walk by an organized table, it's easy as pie. He will sit there for hours, tracing a note, ticket a seller before a ride home. Hot darn politicians raise prices today. Uncle Al is throwing his cigarettes away. He'll keep his cool lid and TV dinner tray. And now, selling chances to me. Pick one out for us there, Brand. Upon visiting Uncle Al one night, I noticed he was sitting in the dark. And from the glow of the TV, I could tell he was watching Jurassic Park. Now, old Al wasn't much into movies, but this one had him hooked. It was that scene where little Timmy's on the fence and electricity has him cooked. So Al was concerned for the child laying there on the ground. And as CPR was given, Al leaned in closer to that old black and white TV. This is how it went down. Back home with a box on movie night, Salisbury steak dinner, a microwave sight. Jurassic Park is on, it seems like a joy. Uncle Al cries, hot darn, they saved that little boy. And he had tears streaming down his face. Hot darn politicians raised prices today. Uncle Lau is throwing his cigarettes away. He'll keep his Kool-Aid and TV dinner tray. Now heading out, selling chances today. Hot darn.
Wow. How long did you carry that one around before you wrote it?
Well, I started playing that in live in the summer of 2020, actually. So, right, a lot of times when I write songs, I try them out to an audience and see if I get any kind of reaction. And I got an immediate reaction on that song from people who were either at the gig and they knew my Uncle Albert, or just a couple people came up and said, I really like that song about your uncle. And then I wanted to do a spoken word part in a song, and I've been messing with that for a long time. And I figured it out. You know, it was one time we were playing it live, and I just started talking during, you know, getting into the last verse. And then I, when I went into the studio to record it, I obviously, you know, wrote syllables and things out just to get a more of a pattern to it, and just loved it. And I, you know, and that's how that kind of came about. And I've got the hot darn movement, Gary, going on at West Claremont High School. I mean, I've got students who are saying it. It's hilarious. I'm like, you know, instead of saying a bad word, just bust out a hot darn. And you can use it in all kinds of ways. You stub your toe, hot darn. Or like, you know, Christmas is a couple of weeks away. Hot darn, let's go. You know, that sort of thing. There's all kinds of ways you can use the use hot darn.
Yeah. Interesting. Good tune.
Thank you.
Where do you perform at that, you know, if people wanted to come out and see you, where do you perform at?
Yeah, so I perform a lot at Alexandria Brewing Company, which is a brewery that's been around for about 3.5 years now, and fantastic owners. I love them, and they love me, and it's a great place. And they really, you know, push original music, which I love, because you know, it can be hard sometimes finding a place that will take you with it as an original act. And so they've been great to me. So Alexandria Brewing Company, and then Sis's on Monmouth, a little restaurant down in Newport. They've been great to me as well over the years. So those are kind of the two main places where I play. And then, you know, I have some festivals here and there, and private parties and whatnot.
Wherever they'll let you break your guitar out and sing.
That's right, Gary. You know that.
Maybe throw a couple of dollars in the box for gas money.
That's right. Absolutely. Yep.
Where's the Alexandria Brewing? Where's that located at?
So that's right on US 27.
Okay.
And it's right by the old Campbell County High School, which is Campbell County, well, it's been like 20 years now.
Right.
Campbell County Middle School. It's right in that area. You go if you're heading south, you go past a Ford dealership and just the Southern Lanes Bowling Alley, which has been there forever, and it's just another mile or so. Right on the left. On the left right there. Yeah.
And of course, Sisters in Newport, they've always had a lot of local talent. They have, and they have different genres of music. They have the Northern Kentucky. Did they call themselves the Bluegrass Band?
I think that's it.
They have Jeff Tuesday Roberts nights, and on Tuesday nights, Jeff Roberts and Chris Cousantino and the guys, and then I think it used to be on Wednesdays. I think they had my buddy Rick Kidman. Rick and I were inducted into the Hall of Fame at the same time.
Nice.
The same. It was Rick and I and Steve Juke and Woodwind and Steel, I believe it was. And we had a great time. It's an honor that they even thought about the country boy like me.
Congratulations! That is a big honor. Yeah,
we'll have to talk to John about that. About some guy I know named Gary Burton.
There you go.
You got another couple songs for me?
Sure. Yeah, we do. Yep.
I'm going to do a plug while Gary's getting set up here.
Okay.
I need to introduce him to the Page Capo. They're coming out with a really, really nice kid. They were in here Sunday and showed their prototype, and they let Miss Dellen Bradley use it this past weekend at her show at the Gaslight Theater, and you'll like it.
Okay, yeah, absolutely, right?
All right, Gary Birch with, you just bareback and like you're in your living room and let people know what you're doing and take off.
Thank you, Gary. So in 2019, I came out with an album called The Bear, and it's about just bearing things. You just gotta put up some things and bear it. And so a lot of songs on that album are about redemption and that sort of thing. So we'd like to play a song called The Mend, and this is about fixing things. One good night and one goodbye. I'll stay the fight and I'll ask the why. It's here and now. Let's clean the slate. You're all alone. And now the wait. It's not an end. This is the mend.
Someone on Facebook, you know how people are.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, everybody. Charles Swift said, "Hot darn." Mm. That was a good song.
Good old Charles Swift, math teacher, West Carolina High School. Thank you, Charles.
What is the tattoo on your right arm?
Well, there are lots. There's a guitar. My niece, Ella, did some artwork on my album, The Bear, and I loved it. And I put this guitar, and she put five birds coming out of the guitar. My wife and I have three boys, and kind of represents that. I'm a big nerd. Like we mentioned Star Wars and Star Trek. I've got some Lord of the Rings stuff going on. Some of my favorite song lyrics that I've written, I've got that going on. There's a bear for the bear, and a couple of other animals, and just
you never know what they ask on Facebook.
Hey, that's fine. Yeah, I mean, yeah.
What else you got for us?
Okay, we've got another new one. So another new song that we've been working on, and the day before Thanksgiving break at school, I told the students wanted to hear Hot Darn Live. They've heard me talk about it, so I played that. But I played this next song, and they seemed to really like it. So we're going to give it a spin. This song is about getting out of your comfort zone, and I try to tell my students, good. Like we usually give a speech at some point in the year. Sometimes smaller speeches, they get really nervous. I'm like, it's good to get out of your comfort zone. You need to feel that, and then and by the end of it, they almost all say, I'm glad I went through that. So this is about getting out of your comfort zone. And like, I've never played live on the radio, Gary. I'm out of my comfort zone. I've been playing live for a lot of years, but but we're having a blast, aren't we, Brandon?
Yes.
This is a lot of fun.
Good.
He's a man of few words.
I see that. I thought he was going to take over the interview there for a minute.
This is called Left Foot Break. Sometimes I break with my left foot just to keep things fresh for my old car. Now then I lay down up on my rooftop just to get closer to those pretty stars. And some people wonder why, and they say, what is wrong with this guy? Well, even clouds need a change, and then they decide to open up and cry. Sometimes I break with my left foot just to keep things fresh from my old car. Now then I lay down up on my rooftop just to get closer to those pretty stars. If it's a challenge you're looking for, well, just try eating yogurt with a fork. Bring more than one string to the ball. In case one breaks, you're ready for the call. Sometimes I break with my left foot just to keep things fresh for my old car. And now then I lay down up on my rooftop just to get closer to those pretty stars. Just to get closer to those pretty stars. Just to get closer to those pretty stars.
Thanks. Remember, kids, there's a quiz tomorrow.
That's right.
Yes, you know, this radio station got started at Claremont Northeastern.
I read that. Yes, I did read that. Claremont Northeastern. Yes, sir.
Yep.
Yeah, I think they got a like an hour delay the other day, or a couple hours. Yeah, 2 hour delay, and we didn't have anything. But whatever, that's all good.
Hey. That when I was going to school, that was a break. Everybody else got a break, and I had to go.
Yeah, right.
You guys got to go no matter what.
Right.
What's the old saying? I had to walk to school uphill both ways in a foot of snow, barefooted.
That's right. Oh yeah, my dad told me that one a few times.
Give us another. You've got a couple more, and give us a couple more, and then we'll break away. How do people get a hold of you if they want to book you or your product? Or so, what do you have, a website?
Thank you. I do. So the website is GaryBirch.com. Now I know Birch Sheet Metal is one of your sponsors.
Spell this.
So it's BERTSCH, but it's pronounced just like Birch Sheet Metal. But it's Gary GaryBertsCH.com. And you can find all kinds of information about my music and all kinds of stuff there. There's a Birch merch store. One of my students a couple years ago said, you should call your merch Birch merch. And so that's kind of funny. And there's that. And of course, my music is on all the major streaming services. You can find it.
Do you have your play dates on there also when you're playing?
Absolutely.
Website.
Yeah, but there's a shows button, and it's got the shows listed. Now, I will say I've been in the studio, and I'm back in the studio. So I'm taking a break from live gigging for a couple of months.
Okay.
Like I said, my oldest son plays basketball for Thomas More University. Let's go Saints. They're off to a great start. They're 8-1. And so I don't want anything to get in the way of it. He's in his last year of college basketball, so I don't want to miss any of those games. And again, I'm in the studio finishing up an EP. So I'm doing like a little 6 or 7 song EP, which Hot Dern will be on. And like I said, I've never released a single, so it's kind of cool doing this. And I might do another single in another month or so, and then get to the EP. And hopefully like by the springtime or before that, and have that out. And then I'll have hopefully lots of dates and you know, people come out and check us out.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Give us a couple more songs and then we'll say goodbye to all the folks and make way for the next segment.
Yeah, thanks, Gary. All right. So we're going to play Voices. This is called Voices, and it's a good foot stomper from my album, The Bear.
Okay.
Voices. Yes, sir.
Gary Burke right here, WOBO 88.7. Give us another.
Sorry.
Quit now.
No, we got it. We are going here. So this is a ballad type song, again, from my 2019 album, The Bear. And this is called Don't Leave a Light On. We walk in a sadness, walk in a blindness. We walk when we don't have to leave. And now something's coming, got me in a binding. Don't leave a light on for me. I'm out on the streets with no name calling. I'm out on the streets, I believe. This tie that binds us will hopefully find us. Don't leave a light on for me. Don't leave a light on. Don't leave a light on. Don't leave a light on for me. I'm sad and I'm lonely. Don't worry, honey. And don't leave a light on for me. Don't leave a light on for me. Don't leave a light on. Don't leave a light on. Don't leave a light on for me. I'm sad and I'm lonely. Don't worry, honey. And don't leave a light on for me. Oh, don't leave a light on for me. Oh, don't leave a light on for me.
All right. Gary, I want to thank you and Brandon for coming in, and I'm going to invite you back. Maybe we can get you in here some Saturday afternoon.
That would be fantastic.
And put you, I'll give you a little tour here when we get done. And put you in the in Studio B live. We have a group and everything. You know, everybody you want to bring with you.
That would be great, Gary, because like I said, I got a lot of blamers.
Great job. great job.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. And again, so you're taking just a little bit of a break from live performances until for a couple months.
Yeah, a couple months. Yeah, back in the studio, putting the finishing touches on some of the stuff, some of the new songs, and then we'll be back at it.
February, March.
Somewhere in there, you know, yeah, ish, somewhere in there, yeah. Yep. Okay.
And again, you can get Gary's music at GaryBurch.com. He's got his Burch merch.
Yeah.
And can they get Hot Dern there right now? Or they
yeah, so Hot Dern is a free download on GaryBurch.com. You go in there and actually when you go there, it'll say name your price and you can put zero in and that's fine. Or you can, like you said before, Gary, a couple bucks or whatever.
And
you get a free download. And I want to thank John Mandel a lot for helping me come in today. And Gary, thank you so much for having us come in. Thank my nephew, Brandon Vieth, for coming here and helping me out.
Bring
really
you back and bring
appreciate it.
Bring your son in and
that'd be great.
You know, have a big jam. And
that'd be awesome.
Maybe we can have pizza and
heck yeah, we like pizza, right?
Yeah, you know, and have a little open jam, so to speak, with Gary Burch. And thank you once again. I appreciate you
thank
coming
you.
In. And,
thank you so much.
Remember Gary's class now. Quiz tomorrow. We're teasing. Maybe not. I don't know. Yeah, right. Gary may say, hey, how many songs did I play?
There you go.
Let me see. I lost count.
But thank you so much for having us.
Brandon, thank you for coming in, my friend. I said, I thought Brandon was going to take over the interview. He talked so much. Got that smile on his face, though, and plays the git joke. That instrument you were hearing there in the background, that's a git joke. They call it a banjo guitar. In bluegrass music, we call it a git joke. Sonny Osborne played a git joke, but he played the three fingers. On some songs, and he did. Check it out. When he, of course, the Osborne Brothers got a lot of flack for being electric, but they opened up shows for Merle Haggard. This is what a lot of people don't understand. They had to go electric because you can't mic an acoustic instrument to play to 10,000 people. Mm-hmm. You know,
right.
So they had to go electric to open up shows for Merle Haggard. And we'll get back to the music. Hold on, Randy Graham. I got all kinds of calls coming in and everything. So anyway, we've got, we'll get back to the music. And Gary, thank you again.
Thank you.
We'll get you back in here. We'll talk a little bit off the air. You've been listening to Gary Birch here at WOBO 88.7 on your FM dial. And I'll be with you for another.